Welcome everybody, I'm Alexander Linz, Head of Content of WatchAdvisor.com. With me today is Matthias Breschan from Rado. Welcome, Matthias.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Alexander, for joining us here in Zurich.
We have two world premieres. That's the first interview WatchAdvisor on YouTube is doing in under, let's say, bright sun. We have never done any interviews or any conversations in the outside, so it's a premiere. And you have also a world premiere for us. For the many years ago, I remember Rado to be either in ceramics, black, deep black, white in different white shades, and let's say the queen of colorful thing was some shiny gray or variations of gray. And now Rado is getting more colorful and colorful, and you have been choosing a nice theme, I would say, from a guy who is born in Switzerland in the heart, also where all you guys, where I am doing my job in the watchmaking country of Switzerland. So it's Monsieur Corbusier now.
Yes, it's actually a guy that is born only 5 kilometers away from our ceramic manufacturing place. He also was actually a watchmaker in his youth. And then I think he had problems with his eyes, and then he moved actually to architecture because he couldn't actually work anymore in the watch industry. So there is actually an emotional link, a geographical link with him.
Does anyone know for whom Le Corbusier worked?
No, at least I do not know.
Okay.
And then for us, why we are now cooperating with this the foundation of Le Corbusier is simply because few years back, ceramic watches was always black, white. Then
gray.
We explored it a bit with our plasma ceramic in the gray color. And then we started actually to explore also the domain of ceramic colors. But very quickly you find out that it's super complex to make ceramic colors, because you have a base material, the zirconium oxide. But as soon as you add some pigments that you need to make colors, it has an influence on the basic structure. And then, of course, you need to find pigments that resist to the sintering temperatures of 1,400 degrees, that are not toxic, that are not destructing the base matrix of the zirconium, which is shock resistance. So you need to limit the pigments to around 5%. You cannot use more of them. So it's extremely complicated and complex to make this color. So we started to explore this in the first step with, I would say, more basic colors like deep green, deep blue, or brown ceramic. But then we said to ourselves, we need to take this to a totally different level. And then we said, yes, but if we take it to a different level, it needs to be meaningful, it needs to make sense to do it. And then we were actually looking around, and very quickly found out that there is only one theory that is worldwide, that is the most respected, the most relevant, that exists for architecture and design, which is Le Corbusier. It's very surprising, actually.
Honestly, I didn't know that. I didn't know.
But it's surprising, because it's a theory, a color theory that is almost 100 years old, and it's still surprising that still today it's the reference when it comes to colors in the world of architecture and design. And then when we looked at this color theory, Corbusier, he defined 63 colors that he considered as being relevant. And then he regrouped these relevant colors in 9 groups. Mm. And these groups, they correspond then to a certain way that he's said how to use those colors and groups in the construction of houses, depending on the light, the walls, painting, etc., etc. Now, for us, the challenge was, of course, that the whole project only would have made sense if we are able to find for each of these 9 groups one color. And that is extremely complicated. And it would not have made sense just to find 5 or 6 colors, because it would not correspond to this whole color theory. So we actually then were working, first of all, on our side, if we get or we have the ability or the capability to do that. And when we got closer and closer, we then contacted Le Corbusier, the foundation, and then Le Couleur Suisse, which is the licensing part of this color theory, and presented them the project. And of course, they were fascinated because for the first time, it was actually something that was brought to the watch industry. They were fascinated by the complexity, the difficulty to achieve it, and that we really have a capability to fit in each of the 9 groups with one of our colors. Mm-hmm. And that's a huge challenge and achievement, and that I think is something very unique that we are able to present today.
Mm-hmm. And I assume it's not a series of only 2-3 pieces. You really showed that Rado is able to manufacture an entire collection. So every of the colors is limited to 999 pieces so far.
Exactly. Yes,
and this shows that you really can stabilize the process, that you're able to really reproduce one, let's say, piece after the other that are identical, and that you have really, that you are mastering the process.
Exactly, because making 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces is not a problem.
I think
you can do this.
But
make it in an industrial way. Do 1,000 pieces or 999 in one color with the bracelet also in ceramic, because this is
matching,
probably the...
Completely matching everything.
Yes, and of course the links on the bracelet, they never come from the same production load, so that the shade of the color is really exactly the same for each link.
I imagine,
for 999 pieces, that's a huge challenge.
I imagine it's a nightmare.
It is.
It is, yeah. So how long did it take those, let's say, technicians, guys who worked behind to really get so far that they could say, okay, now we're ready, we can stabilize the process, we can reproduce how many you want, Matthias? How long did it take them?
Well, I think we're exploring now with ceramic colors, in addition to the black, white, and silver ceramic already since almost 10 years.
Okay.
And then the first step, that was like 6 years ago, we brought this deep blue, deep green, and brown ceramic. And then it was actually a simultaneous process where we really explored with other colors. Some colors we were not able to reproduce because...
Can you name one, for instance?
Well, for example, when it gets to very light or very vivid colors, because the structure, some pigments, they just burn at 300 degrees.
Okay.
So you're never able to go to 1,400, which we need in our sintering process.
But there is a process called cold sintering or something I've learned.
Yes.
That could work, but it's difficult.
It's this high pressure, low temperature sintering, that's true. It's a very difficult process. It's a process I would almost consider it still in a quite industrial phase, but yes, it's a direction to probably offset...
One day to be also able to manufacture.
Exactly, yes. Yeah. But for us, of course, what is interesting is then not only to make one or two pieces, really to have a whole series. Yeah.
But once you're able to do this, maybe one day you can do any color you want.
Absolutely, yeah.
So,
yeah.
999 pieces, but I don't think you're going to stop the whole thing then.
No, definitely not. This is now our first step, and of course we have then a concept as a second step to do with these colors and the cooperation with Corbusier in a second step that I hopefully will be able to speak to you next year.
I hope so. And what I could imagine is that you probably could set really color trends with also the fashion industry, because I assume this is very much targeting a younger generation of buyers. You're let's say lowering also the segment of your age of buyers. It's very attractive to young people, such watches, to say, okay, I'm wearing today blue, let's take this really marine blue, and I'm wearing jeans or something, and then the other day, okay, I want to show off a little bit, I take an orange. And so you could really go and say, okay, let's develop colors that really go perfectly fit with I don't know, a famous fashion designer.
We are working on this also.
I think so.
So we are also to go to present you something maybe still this year about
in
this
imagine,
direction.
Because this is so...
But you're totally right. I mean, nobody today buys a watch only to read the time.
No. That's a fashion statement.
And then, of course, selecting like you select your clothes, like you select your outfit... depending also on what you're doing through the day or on the mood you are in, you want also to really choose the right accessory and in particular the right watch that really fits to what you're doing or the mood you are in.
So what mood is this, guys? The yellow, we don't know.
That's the sun. Sunny day in Zurich.
This is why I took it, yeah. It's a sunny day in Zurich. I think that's the perfect way. Thank you. Matthias, once again, as we say in French, chapeau. I really, I'm very impressed because I know I'm pretty much into the difficulties of manufacturing high-tech ceramics, and we have been talking very often about difficult way of manufacturing it the last years, and I know how difficult it is, and I know how you always said you a couple of times you said I would like to do so many colors, but it's so difficult. So really, congratulations also to your team.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think what is really why we were actually able at the end to do this is because we control the industrial base ourselves. We manufacture this ourselves in Switzerland.
Swatch Group.
Exactly. Yes, and it's our decision to take this risk, to invest. And we are making sure with this to be innovate and continue to be innovate because, as you know, the day you don't take risk, you stop innovating things, and the day you stop innovation, you start killing a brand.
Yeah. 100% Swiss made, 100% Swatch Group. Very nice. 100% Rado, of course.
Yes.
But it's, as I told you, chapeau to all your technicians, designers, whatever, watchmakers. Really, I'm impressed.
Thank you very much,
Alexander. I'm very much impressed because you have to do this. It's not just showing something with a different color on the wrist. It's impressive.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much for coming to see us here in Zurich.
I was happy to be here. Thank you guys for watching. So if you are impressed as I am, please use the comment section just here underneath. Ask me some questions if you want. I will be more than happy to get back to you. Thanks for watching as always. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to like our videos. And bye-bye for now. And once again, wonderful sun. Oh, turn it around in the right way. I take the sunny side of life. Bye, guys.